Hey, it's Aziz Ansari. We're here watching a clip from season 3 of Master of None. I'm with Naomi Ackie, who plays Alicia, and we're about to watch a scene from episode 4 where her character is going through the arduous journey of IVF.
Okay.
From all the conversations I had with women, friends of friends that have done this, that this first injection moment is quite interesting and intimidating. And Naomi, you say some stuff.
Yeah, I remember we had the IVF experts in and they were teaching me how to do the mixing stuff. So they were real like needles, except for the one that I put in my body. But the first needle, super, super intimidating. And it's just so complicated.
You, because you are fucking huge.
And originally it was gonna be like, oh, we're gonna cut to a clock and show some time passing, we're gonna split it up, and then, you know, we were talking about the scene and you told me like, hey, I just think we should just hold on this spot, I'll just walk off camera, come back, and I was like, whoa, that's exactly right, that's what we're doing here, we're gonna live in this moment with her. And do it that way. I also just want to mention the actress that plays your mom is the amazing Marianne Jean-Baptiste, who won a lot of acclaim and awards for her performance in Secrets and Lies. So I was so excited we got to work with her, and she was awesome. And you guys really had the same like British accents and everything.
Hello.
Hi, Mum.
Hello, darling. How are you doing?
I'm just trying to do this this injection thing, and it's like really hard.
Oh. Well, can't somebody from the hospital come over to do it for you?
No, Mum. If I ask them to come over, I've got to spend like £200 every visit. It's like ridiculously expensive.
She's in the States, and so she was actually calling through the phone, so we would just like be like, okay, Marianne, we're gonna do a take. When I call you next, it's the real thing. And then we'd like click. Yeah. And then she'll call back. And it was a really cool way. I feel like that there was a warmness in my heart doing this scene, because it was like talking to like one of my aunties or something like that. Like the voice and the accent was so present and is present in my family and stuff, that it was really easy for me to just be like, oh yeah, that sounds like my mum. Yeah.
I'm not being funny, but it just kind of feels like there's just so much stuff, and it's like the universe is trying to tell me that I'm not meant to have a kid. Do you know what I mean?
I love your performance in this, because you really get what this added layer of Alicia doing this by herself without a partner, and how much harder it is. Injecting yourself with a needle, it's a scary thing. And to think that, you know, when you do this, it's something you do twice a day or however many times a day for however many weeks. It's, you know, it's a lot.
It's a lot. It's a lot. I think there was something really special as well about, you know, so a woman wanting to be a mother, calling her mother for support. And there's like a nice kind of that moment there as well.
All right. Look, let's just take a deep breath, because you're giving me anxiety already. And the child ain't born yet. All right. Yeah.
The ladies we have as the mothers in this, we have Angela Bassett and Marianne Jean-Baptiste. I mean, wow. And it's cool because, you know, in the episode before this, it's Denise calling her mom, calling Angela on the phone, calling Catherine, Denise's mom's character name, but it's Angela Bassett. And, you know, she's calling her for support. And then in this episode, you call your mom for support. And the whole thing is about, you know, her wanting to be a mom. I just really liked how all that worked out and how they're both ended up being phone calls. And we lucked up.
You ready?
Yeah, I just got to get my belly out. 1 second. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm ready.
Right. Good. One.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Two. Three.
Oh my God.
Come on.
It's done. I did it. It's not even that bad.
can't say enough about Naomi and how much you brought to the story. It's you know, to do a scene like this and, you know, you feel sad for her, you feel scared for her, and you laugh and everything. You get the full range from this, and it's a scene where there's no one else on camera. So I'm very lucky that I got to work with you on this, and I'm glad we made this together.